हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज पार्ट 13 ऑफ सी प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज वीडियो सीरीज। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल कवर दीज कंटेंट्स: नीड ऑफ एरे, वन डायमेंशनल एरे, टू डायमेंशनल एरे एंड थ्री डायमेंशन और मल्टी डायमेंशन एरेज। नीड ऑफ एरेज, व्हाई वी नीड ऑफ एरेज? बिफोर अंडरस्टैंडिंग एरे, कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग प्रोग्राम। दिस इज मेन फंक्शन। We take two variable int x and assign 5 value to x and 10 value to x. Okay, so here we print the x value. So x is equal to x. So this will print the 10 value. Why? Because the 5 value will loss, because the compiler remember latest value. So the latest value is x equal to 10. So this is the old value. X is equal to 5. This is the old value. So the compiler forget, and the latest value remember, and this latest value will print by the compiler. So this is the problem in the simple variable using. Okay. So this is the explanation of earlier program. The program print value of x as 10 because x is equal to 10 value is latest value, and x is equal to 5 value is lost. Okay. Ordinary variable are capable of holding only one value at a time. If we want to store more than one value at a time in a single variable, for example, suppose we want to arrange percentage marks obtained by 100 students. In this case, we have two options to store these marks in memory. First, construct 100 variables to store percentage of marks obtained by 100 different students, that is each variable containing one student's marks. And second option is that construct one variable called array capable of storing all 100 values. So in first options, we should make 100 variables, and each variable store one student marks. Okay. So this is the very lengthy problem, because the program code will get lengthy. Okay. But we take only one variable, that is the array, and we store 100 student marks in a single variable. So this can easy our code, means this reduce the program size of our program. So now, array. An array is a collection of similar elements. These similar elements could be all ints or all floats or all characters. So similar means, suppose this is the example to declare array int student marks 100. So this is the size of array, this is the name of array student marks, and this is the data type. So it means integer data type student marks store 100 marks of a student. So it will store only similar types, means float, character, not dissimilar types. Okay. So this array represent marks of 100 students. Types of arrays: first is one dimensional arrays, second is two dimensional arrays, and third is multi dimensional or three dimensional arrays. One dimensional arrays: a list of items can be given one variable name using only one subscript, and such a variable is called a single subscripted variable or a one dimensional array. So this is the single subscript. Okay. If we want to represent a set of five numbers as 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50 by an array variable number as follows. So in this, we declare array variables integer type, so int num 5. So in this 5, this is the size of array, we can store these all five numbers in a single variable. So this is a kind of array. Okay, so the computer reserves five storage locations as shown below. Okay, so the five element will store in this sequence. Means this is the zero index, this is the 1, 2, 3, 4. So the zero index will store 10 and in one index will store 20. So this is the memory of the array. Okay, so this each element is stored in a different block in a memory. Okay, so the value of the array element can be assigned as follows. So the number means zero index or in a zero place, the 10 value will store. Okay, in one index in array will store 20 values. So in this index or in this sequence, the all elements will store. Okay, this would cause the array element can be assigned as follows. So similarly, this is the memory occupied by the or each elements of the array. Okay, declaration of one dimensional array. Like any other variable, array must be declared before used. Okay, so this is the syntax: type, variable name and size. So we declare any type and the variable name, and we declare the size. Okay, so these are the examples: float length 60. So the length we can store 60 length and in a float type values. Okay, and int salary, so we can store 20 salary numbers in like integer, and character name 11. So we can store 11 character in this array. So here we see the example how to store the character in memory. So this is the frame and this is the blank space ARYA, and this is the last is the null character. Okay, so in character type data type, so the last variable means last word is a null, because this null indicates the all character or this all string end. So this null will store. So in character type, we should use one additional means one additional space. Okay, for the character data type. So here, the when declare the character array, we must allow one extra element space for the null terminator. So this is terminate our character string. Okay, initialization of one dimensional array. After an array is declared, its element must be initialized, otherwise it will contain garbage values. Okay, array can be initialized at two stages. First is at compiler time and second is runtime. So at compile time, initialize the elements of array in the same way as the ordinary variable are declared. So this is the form of how to initialize the element of array type. This is the array name size. So here this list of values. So we can write the values and initialize the values. So this is the example. Int num 5. So this is the 5 size of array, and we can store the 5 element. So we cannot store the 6 element because this is the out of limit of array. So it will generate the error by the compiler. Okay, so these are the valid examples of initialization of array. Float total 5. So we store the only 1, 2 and 3 elements, and we initialize on 3 elements, but we not initialize last 2 elements. So the array or the compiler will automatically assign two last variable 00. Okay, here this is the also valid form. We can directly initialize the numbers in array without giving the size of array. Okay, this is also the character type and this is the null. Okay, character name. So these are the valid valid declaration of the array. Okay. At runtime initialization, an array can be explicitly initialized at runtime. This approach is usually applied for initializing large array. We can also use a read function such as scanf to initialize an array, for example. So we give the size of 4. Okay, so here we scan, means we store the 4 elements in array. We take 4 time of %d and we store 4 elements. In a index 0 we can store one element, and in a index 1 we can store second element, and in third and fourth we can store 4 elements. So it will initialize array element with the value entered through the keyword. Okay, so this is the runtime initialization of array. So the runtime initialization benefit is that we should not declare the size of the array, because it saves the memory of the array. Okay, so this is the program of array. We take average and sum, two variables, and here in the another is the I variables. We declare the array marks 5, so array declaration, and we use the loop and run 5 times, because we start from 0, it will run 5 times. Okay, so it will first time enter marks. Okay, so the compiler ask the users enter marks. So this will first ask the enter marks. So the user will give the marks, suppose 70. So this scanf function will scan or store the 70 value in memory. So this will store the data in array. Okay, and in the second time the compiler go back, and the for loop second time will run, because the condition is true. The second time again ask enter marks. In second time ask enter marks, so we give the 85, and similarly we give the all 5 marks, 79. Okay, this array will complete, and this compiler go to the in the next for loop. Okay, so in next for loop the all values is stored in this array, and one by one value pass in the next for loop. So here the one value pass, because the condition is checked, and the one value pass. So the one value we entered 70, so the 70 value pass, and in this marks I, so the 70 value will add with sum. So we declare sum equal to 0, so 0 plus 70, so the 70 value will sum and store in some variable. Okay, and the next time this for loop again run, because condition is true, so 2 less than equal to 4. So the second time value will pass, so the second value will pass 85. So already some have 70 values and 85, so this add 70 plus 85, so the 155 value will store in sum. Similarly the all values sum to each other and store in some value. Okay, and the loop is terminated, so the compiler or the pointer go to the average, and the all sum divided by the 5, and the result is stored in the average, and in this print will print the average, means the all 5 values sum and divide by 5, so the average will print by the marks. Okay, so the average will print the 83. Okay, so I think you understand the how to work array in this program. Two dimensional arrays. We have stored a list of values in one dimensional array, but we want to store values in table form. So it is possible by using two dimensional arrays. So a 2D array is also called a matrix. Okay, so this is the table form, and we see these are the rows and these are the columns. Okay, so in each row stored three values. Okay, 3 values. this table contain 12 values, means these are the all 12 values. So 3 in each line, each line means each row. So this table like a matrix of 4 rows and 3 columns, each row represent value of sales. Okay, each row represent the value of salesman and each column represent the item values. Okay, declaration of two dimension arrays. Mathematical representation of a matrix using two subscript like mij. So ij represent the row and column. So here m denotes the entire matrix and ij refer to the value in ith row and jth column. So this is the general form of two dimensional array. This is the type, means integer float and array name, row size and column size. So we declare the two size of the array, means this represent the row and this represent the column size. Okay, so we take the example, a small example, 4 and 3. So this represent the 4 rows and 3 represent the column. Okay, so in this picture shows how to store array element in the memory. So here we give the each elements and this is the matrix form. So this is the row and column. So suppose we see 0 0, so this 0 0 place is store the 1 5 element. Okay, and this is the row, suppose this is 230. So 230 store in the place 0 and 2, because row is a 0 and column is a 2. Okay, suppose in the last 163 store 3 2. Okay, so 3 represent row and 2 represent the column. Okay, so I think you understand the how to store array elements in the memory. So this is the program of multiplication table of 1 to 5. Okay, so this we define the preprocessor directive. So in the preprocessor directive, we already make a video, complete video, how to preprocessor work, how to define. So you can see the video, you can see the video and understand the preprocessor directive. So we take the two directive, declare row 5 and column 5s. Okay, so here we take the variable int I, j, row, column, product, rows and columns, and this will print the multiplication table. So this will print the simple statement multiplication table. So this will print in the output, we can see the multiplication of the table. Okay, and this for loop will print the this is this column 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, for j equal to 1, j less than equal to column, j plus plus. So this column will print 1 2 3 5 times, 5 time column, and this print will j. Okay, and print f n, and the next time this line will print by this printf. So this line will print by this printf, and the control go to the in this for loop for I is equal to 0, I rows and I plus plus. So this will print the row. So the control go to the here row and I plus 1. Okay, so this will print first time row 1. So this will print 1, and this will line means this symbol will also print here. Okay, so this printf, or this will print one time, will print, and this will loop execute, and the second time this will print. Okay, so this will print first time. Okay, so in the next, in the loop, this will print the multiplication of the row and the column. Okay, so in the next, this column this will loop execute. So first time the column is equal to j. So this is the condition, column equal to j. So this is the assign value j, means column have the value 1. Okay, so the 1 is equal to 1. Okay, so print f means product I and j. So here row is a 1 and column is a 1. So this is the row and this is the row and this is the column. So here row and multiply by column, and the result will store in the product. and this will print the one. Okay, row and one. And the next time this for loop again run second time. So this the second time will again print will multiply. So the row is already one and the column is a two. So the one into two. So this will print the two. Okay. So this all values print in the row one. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Or the we understand the column. So all column will print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So one time this will print and this the loop exit because the one row will print. Or all column 5 will value print here. So the this loop terminate and the go to the this for loop, right? Okay. So the row will increase by 1 and the next time the second row will print. So that this the 2 value will print and the again and this all for loop again print the all values. Means multiply all values with the column and rows. Okay, so similarly the all values multiplication print and this n means the one row print and the control pass to the new line means the next time the new value will print from the next line. Okay, so this is the functionality of multiplication, how to multiply the row and the column of the values. Okay, initialization of 2D array. So like one dimension array, 2D array can be initialized as follows. So int table 2, 3. So here we declare 2, 3 means the 6 element we declare. Okay, so 3 element in a row and 3 element in a column. Okay, so this is the 3 element 0, 0, 0 and 1, 1, 1. These are the two rows means this is the row means in three element and this is the again second row. Okay, so the element first row to 0 and the second row to 1. Okay, so it is a row by row initialization. The above statement can be equivalent as follows. So int table 2, 3, so this is the three zeros in the first rows and the one is the second rows. Okay, we can also initialize 2D array in matrix form as shown below. We can initialize in this form means 3, 0 means 2 rows and 2 rows and 3 columns. Okay, so this is the also valid form and we can initialize in this form. But we can give only one size and this is the blank. So this is the also valid form. Okay, multi-dimension array or three-dimension array. The arrays of 3D or more dimension, the exact limit is determined by the compiler. The general form of multi-dimension array is as follows. So type array name S1, S2, S3 and SM. Where si is the size of ith dimension. Some following example are int survey. So this survey will store 3, 5, 12. So this is the size of the array, 3 dimension. And float table, this is the 4 dimension array. Okay. So this survey is the 3 dimension array declared to contain 180 integer type element. So we multiply to each other 3 into 5 and 5 into 12. So this is the 180 integer. Okay, and similarly 4 dimension table array containing 300 elements of floating point table. So we multiply to each other, so the size is the 4 dimension array is 300. Okay, the array survey may represent the survey data of rainfall. Okay, so during the fall during the last 3 years from January to December in 5 cities. So this is the representation of array, how to represent the elements. Okay, so this picture shows of represent the rainfall example. So if the first index denotes a year, the second city and the third month, then the element survey. Okay, so this the element, the first element represent year, okay, and the second represent the city, and the third represent the month. Okay, so the second year means the second is represent second year, and this the second element represent the city means third, and the then the element survey represent the 10 means October. Okay, so denotes the rainfall in the month of October during the second year in city third. Okay, so this is the meaning of the this array. Okay, so the third 3D array can represent as series 2D array as shown. Okay, so this is the look like as a 2D array, but this is the actual of the 3D array because this is the month 1, 2, 3 to 12 months. Okay, and this is the also city here 1, 2, 3, 5 cities, and this is the year 1 data, and this is the year 2 data. Okay, so this is the 3 dimension array, but look like as a 2 dimension array. Initialization of 3 dimension array, so we can initialize this is the first of the size means 3 4 2, so this is the 4 into 3 means 12, and 12 into 2 means 24. Okay, so 24 size of the all elements represent here. Okay, so we initialize 3D array in this form. Bounds checking. If the subscript used for an array exceeds the size of the array, this will lead to unpredictable result. There will be no message generated. In some cases, the computer may just hang. The following program may be suicidal or dangerous. Okay, so if we this example shows, if we represent the size 40 or we define the 40 size and we use the array exceed the 40 size, so this may be dangerous because the array use the 40 size and we run the 100 times, so compiler work the misbehave because the 100 time it will run, but the size of the 40, so it may be the system hang. Okay, so this may be harmful of the system or the programmer. Okay, passing array element to a function. Array element passed to a function by calling the function by value or by the reference. So in call by value, pass the value of array element to the function, and call by reference, pass address of array element to the function. So I think this call by value and call by reference we already use in the swapping program. Okay, so we in this program we pass this is the display function, and in this display function we pass the actual value. These are the values. Okay, 5, 3, 8. These actual values of the array passed to the display function. So one by one value we pass to the function, and the actual value will print. Okay, so here we pass the value. So we pass the one by one value to the function, and it will print the actual value. Okay, so this is the passing the value or passing the value to the function. Okay, and this is the also same program, and here this is the simple small difference. We pass the address of the variable. So we pass the address, suppose we 5 value address pass to the display function. So we use the pointer. Okay, so if we not use the pointer, so this will print the address of the 5, but we use the pointer, so pointer will print the actual value of the marks I means this will store 5 and 3 in the 0 index, 2 index, 3 index. Okay, so this will print the actual value. So here we can see the passing the address of the reference. Okay, so we pass the reference to the function and value at the address operator. So this is the value at address. Okay, so this is the value, so this will print the value at address. Okay, this will print the actual value. Pointers and arrays. So here we can see int I equal to 3 and this is the pointer of x. So we take the float type of values here, and here we take the character type. So in this print we print the I value. So this will print just the 3, and the second printer will print the j value. So j will value print in 1.5. so in output you can see the value of I will print and j will print and c value will print. Okay, in this statement x is the address of I. So we use the address of each variable. So this will print the address of each variable I, j and k. And in next time we use plus, means one increment in each variable, and again the print x, y and z. So this will print 1044, 208 and 507. So this understand. Okay, so the first time the original address of x is the 2 and 1002, and next time this will print the address 1004. So why? Because the integer take 2 bytes. Okay, so this will print the or occupy the memory sequentially. So this will print increase by 2, because this is the integer type. So this will memory location increase by 2. So this will print the 1004. Okay, and this is the new address of the second is the float. Okay, so this float will increase 4 time. Okay, so because float take 4 bytes, this will print the 4 means 4 place forward. Okay, so this will print 2008. And in next the character store 1 byte, so this will print 5007. So this will increase 1 time. Okay, so I think you understand the concept of the pointer and array. So thank you very much, and if you have any query to you can write in the comment box. Thank you.